Worcestershire.
Worcestershire.
Is that what it is?
Worcestershire.
What did I say?
Worcestershire.
Isn't that what it is?
It's Worcestershire.
Is it Worcestershire? Wishushu. Hi, I'm Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
We do, we do.
And today we're watching Love is Blind Season 4, a Netflix original program where sexy singles see if they can fall in love without seeing each other to answer the question, is love blind? It's an experiment to see how many seasons it's gonna take for Nick Lachey to marry me, and so far, four.
He's hosting this?
He always does.
Oh my God.
And his wife, Vanessa.
Vanessa Hudgens?
No, we've watched this together. You've seen her.
Who are you? The crux of this show rests on riveting suspense that is revealed over the course of the season. So if you are wanting to keep that suspense alive and avoid spoilers, please turn back now.
I will say for this show particularly, part of the allure is, yeah, are they gonna get married? So don't let us ruin it. This competition, there's no money to be won. I mean, sure, after the fact, you can get your little Colgate endorsement.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I love finding love, but more than that, I love healthy Crest gums, you know?
Like. Yeah. Finding love is like finding the right financial advisor. Merrill Lynch, yes.
I mean, people get married because someone's pregnant. Might as well get married for TV. Who cares?
Yeah, for money, for fame. Those things has weight.
Relationships, love,
flimsy,
money,
fleeting.
That's a lifetime.
Yeah, legacy work.
What I won't do is what some of these people do, which is get to the altar and then say no in a wedding dress. Because that's cruel.
That's drama. That's
drama. But I hope it happens. Vanessa and Nick Lachey explain the experiment.
He's here. I just have to find him.
Elementary school teacher.
It's a pretty broad variety of professional.
Marketing manager.
Oh, there's a couple of marketing managers.
Girl, they're fudging those lower thirds.
Marketing manager.
Marketing manager.
Mama,
Zales.
Thank you.
You might call me old fashioned or whatnot, but that's not me.
My goon is call me old fashioned.
Because it can mean anything.
Literally, I shuck corn at 5 a.m.
Old fashioned. I think I should be able to have multiple wives.
Yeah, I drink unpasteurized milk straight from the teat.
I want there to be all hot young influencers and then one very traditional Amish German speaking, like Jacomi Mendelsohn.
In the
and
corner,
he has like
a quill with a calligraphy.
He has a quill and a long beard. And he's like, I'm here for my wife. All right, so Tiffany and Brett finally work up to saying how they feel about each other.
I already feel as though I'm in love with you.
She's really feeling at home.
Hello?
Left on red in the pod.
In real life.
She's snoring. She's got so comfortable.
Hello?
Hello? No!
She took a goofball.
No!
She took a Zanny and conked out.
I feel bad for her because she's just tired.
Mama.
And now he's like, well, f*** you, bitch.
You, bitch.
No, no. Listen, I feel for her because I fall asleep really quickly.
I feel like I could fall asleep right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I have fallen asleep in the middle of conversations.
Yeah.
You ever fallen asleep on the phone?
No, not on the phone, because I would.
Fall asleep on the phone.
On the phone? But what are you talking about? You're just like, you're mumbling.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't like that.
And maybe there was drinking involved. Maybe I get drunk and call people.
You fall asleep during a prank call.
When drunk people call me, I hate it so much. But then for some reason, when I'm drunk, I'm like, we gotta call her up. My mom, what, 2 a.m.? She's up.
She's
or
up.
She'll get up.
Oh, she'll get up when I call her for the fourth time in a row. Our first proposal, Brett asks Tiffany to marry him. And this is big for Brett. And it's also big for Tiffany.
Okay, so I accidentally fell asleep.
Please make her feel bad for sleeping.
Because I was listening to your voice and it's so soothing.
Mr. Sandman, you soothed me to sleep.
You know when a celebrity is like underrated and people are like, people sleep on her. People actually slept on
her.
I feel like you understand me.
She's sleeping again. Could you imagine? Or I hope he tries to give her a taste of her own medicine, but he does like bad cartoon sleeping, like
Kong Shu me me me.
Will you marry me?
Yes.
Touching the void.
Could you tell if you're attracted to someone with your eyes closed by just touching their face?
No,
no,
no. No. I could palpate some landmarks I was definitely not interested in.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
That's like a large
tooth coming straight out of the, you know what I mean? Things like that.
A tusk.
But then you never know.
You never know.
You never know.
I'm really open. I have some really horrible looking people, and been but been so turned on.
Talk about it.
And I have some really hot people, and it was horrible.
Yeah. So Tiffany and Brett are gonna see each other for the first time after getting engaged.
The moment where they see each other for the first time is so exciting because it's either chilly because they're normal people who, even though they've fallen in love, they're like, this is weird. Or they're horny.
Has anybody ever just gone out in like pasties and like a French cut thong?
No, they usually do like little slip dresses, okay. Little body dresses.
Now, would you be polite and not let your true like feelings be known once you saw a dog before you? Although, you f*** with the lights off.
I think they really like each other.
They seem pretty well matched.
The show is also all about like copyright-free yearning pop music clips.
Oh, really?
So they'll meet for the first time and the music will be like, it's like I see you for the first time, you know. We have a second proposal and we have Paul asking Micah to marry him.
Now, this is huge for Paul, but let's not forget, this is a pretty big deal for Micah.
When a good old Southern boy throws on some pants like that, he means fucking business. You know?
He looks insane.
He looks like Tiny Tim.
The waist of those pants go up to just an inch under his nipples, and he is wearing a bolero blouse.
I know. He's an environmental scientist. His job is not to be fashion.
Mama, it's nobody's job to be fashion besides fashion.
He's trying to make the environment fashion.
Will you marry me?
I mean, I'd marry him.
You would?
He's gorgeous. Yeah, he's 4 feet tall and he dressed like a toy soldier, but... Is she gonna say no?
I don't know, I feel so confident. It's gonna be a zesty life.
Zesty? Creamy Italian?
She's got a couple jade eggs up there right now.
So, yes, Paul.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we got Micah and Paul seeing each other for the first time.
Now, this is a huge moment for Micah, but it's also pretty big for Paul.
She smelled great, her hair was beautiful, her eyes are beautiful, makeup was perfect, her dress was perfect.
I love this show, and you can't stop me.
You're so handsome.
Thank you, yeah.
He's so hot.
Gorgeous. So Marshall is gonna propose to Jackie.
Goes without saying, for both Jackie and Marshall, it's gonna be big.
Jackie was very serious with Josh in the pods, but she chooses Marshall.
I'm glad that you responded that way because it showed me that you cared. Josh is a grown-ass man. He can handle his emotions and he'll be just fine.
Will you marry me, Jackie?
Of course I'll marry you.
In every soul, in every realm.
He fell down. He's in diabetic shock.
In every soul, in every realm?
These people are psycho! And they say we're mentally ill. They go on the news and call us mentally ill.
Yeah, Mama, check yourself in your pod. Now, Jackie and Marshall are gonna see each other for the first time after getting engaged.
Oh, he's so cute.
Smitten, regardless. Peg leg, solid gold
tooth. Did she say peg leg? Solid gold tooth?
Does he think she's gonna be a buccaneer? What the f*** is he? He's like, I don't care if she gets off a ship and has a parrot on her shoulder.
If she works at Pirates of the Caribbean, it doesn't matter to me. Like, she could be one-eyed.
You know what? She might have a beard that's a squid. By the way, I hope she's in earshot. She's like, oh, he's talking about me. Do I sound like I have a peg leg? By the way, hotness is not related to having both legs.
Oh, no.
That's not even relevant.
No. Or a gold tooth.
Teeth is not relevant to hotness.
I know.
If I smell halitosis, that's a deal breaker. Because there's no cure. You won't have to live with that for the rest of your life.
That is absolutely patently untrue, what she just said.
About halitosis?
Yeah, I don't know what dental field she thinks she's working in.
Right.
But she is spewing lies and vicious rumors. This is big for Marshall. But with all that Jackie's been through,
I don't think she likes it.
No.
I don't think she likes it.
She doesn't. No. 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 Oh, I don't like it.
I don't know about this one.
No. They are.
I don't know about this one.
Nope.
So Zach's having a hard time picking between Bliss and Irina.
Yeah.
And Bliss tells him that Irina's not a great person. Is he crying?
I want to read something to you.
Here we go, baby. Here we go, baby. Are they doing poetry?
True love has the power to redeem. Love saves us.
I would have already walked out.
Yeah.
Are you breaking up with me?
Yeah, he is. Girl, they get people on here on the brink of self-destruction. It's so fierce.
Although, you know what? It is terrible rejecting people. It's the worst
much
thing ever.
Easier to be rejected.
Absolutely.
So we got Kwame proposing to Chelsea. I love the name Kwame.
That's pretty big news for Kwame.
I had like all
all my outfits picked out with black jeans. But the crazy thing is, I put on a pair of my light tan khakis and mm-hmm. I looked in the mirror, I was like, damn, that, you know what? That looks good.
What is happening?
Always think about how incredibly real we can be.
You don't have to do Shel Silverstein.
No.
You don't have to do—
You know, Jane Austen, Emily Bronte.
Frost.
Yeah.
You could just say, let's do it, or let's not do it.
Yeah.
Our love story was the most beautiful slow dance.
Blue. Our love was like an Orange Julius.
Yeah, and it was like a walk through a car wash.
All right, so we got Kwame and Chelsea seeing each other for the first time. He's adorable, she's adorable. Oh, I think they like each other.
I love the nails. That's a fabulous manicure.
Yeah.
Wait, are we gonna do this sitting? We should get up.
We should.
Oh, she's Bridezilla.
I like that. She's like, we're not doing this sitting, are we?
Remember, who has more game, me or you?
Wow.
She's reading. Zach proposes to Irina.
I would say in the grand scheme of things, this is probably the biggest moment for Irina.
This is the one that Bliss said was being shady.
Now, she's a first-generation Russian. If we know anything about that, we'll know she's a scheming, lying bitch.
So I wrote you a song.
Aww. A song?
It was aching, breaking down. The bluest guy the blues had found.
As we I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it.
I knew it was real, my heart you would steal.
You know what, listen, everybody sings at different levels, and singing is joyous. It's joyous.
I found myself a Blarney Stone.
Irina, I really think you're sweet and hot. Should we call someone?
I'm worried that this is gonna be what brings Netflix down. It's like because we didn't say anything. We didn't quality control. I can't believe how long this is. Irina's like, if I say yes, will you stop singing? The way he stopped singing and was like, okay, I ate. The way he was like, he's well, like, record contract in 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, I'll hold for applause.
Someone being a bad singer can be very cute.
Absolutely.
If you have like a fun boyfriend who sucks at singing but loves karaoke, it's adorable.
It's adorable. That's also context dependent.
Exactly.
Karaoke involves everybody together, no expectations, drinking, camaraderie, conviviality. I sing in the car at the top of my lungs.
Uh-huh.
I'm alone.
Yeah. There's a lot of variables here. So we have Irina and Zach seeing each other for the first time after that compelling rendition
of
original
exquisite
music.
Poetry.
I cannot wait to see what the love of my life looks like.
Business owner, that sounds so made up, MLM.
Yeah, totally.
Herbalife.
Yeah, Herbalife. She's trying to bust into the Tijuana skinnies. She's trying.
Nice to meet you, by the way.
You want to sit down?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. You look like something out of like a cartoon.
Women don't want to f*** cartoons.
I have to blink.
I am blinking.
You don't blink.
Oh, they don't like each other.
No.
I've cast the runes. Mm. I've looked at the tea leaves.
No.
And I don't like what I see.
No.
I don't like what I see. So they leave the pods to go to a luxury resort in Mexico where they start spending the night together. Now, everyone has consummated their relationship except
the spy and the folk singer.
Yes. I would have let Zach have it the first night.
I kind of imagine him to be kind of from that little shirtless thing.
No.
Like the, you know,
no, I would have snapped that dick clean off.
Did you like feel weird when you woke up next to me? For a split second I did. I was like, oh boy, not this again.
Girl.
Like already feels like we're best friends.
She sucks. Sorry, Irina.
Irina, you need to like get your head in the game. There's no prize to win here.
All the couples come together for a cocktail party post-coitus.
They know people of their own gender from their own dorms, but they're not totally clear on who went with who and who's actually still there.
I think you're so great too.
It's a fine line of like, hey, I know you're with her, let's be friends. But this is flirting.
This is flirting.
Oh my God.
She's flop.
She's like an evil Snooki. She has,
what the
she has 80% of her breasts out underneath her top.
Mama, by the way, kiss your fiance.
Yeah.
This is the problem. It's neither his or her fault.
Yeah.
They just don't go together. I love anything like this that just reveals human truths.
Yeah.
These people at the end of the day can't escape what they actually think about each other.
It's true.
And eventually they come clean. Can't fight the moonlight. Leanne Rimes tried it.
Yeah, she was right.
Let's
Like, there's a difference between, like, any other guy hugging me and there's Zach hugging me. It's just not there, and I don't know if it's gonna grow.
Oh, she sucks.
At this stage, usually people start to figure out, ooh, he's a little more controlling than I wanted.
Right.
Ooh, she's a little bit of a bitch.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is the first time there's been somebody brazenly like, I don't like him. Yeah. This is really odd.
I shot for a failed proposal.
That was mean.
Ugh.
I'm just kidding.
Drunk.
They're giving Newcastle.
They're giving Essex.
Yeah. After the cocktail party, Marshall and Jackie are talking about all the couples.
Zach is a weirdo and Irina. A peasant.
I love this show because it's so f-ing weird.
It's so f-ed up.
It's so weird.
It's like, Zach is a weirdo and Irina, the peasant.
That is fierce. The dental assistant.
Dr. Halitosis over here.
English peasantry type. I mean,
old maiden type of shoes. Irina was not, she was unqualified.
Listen, I love a creative read. And she's the dental assistant too, and she's like, and she should really get her number 6 molar looked up. Honestly.
All the other couples are mixing, mingling, bonding, thriving, and Zach and Irina are doing nothing of the sort.
Does it like bring you down at all? How I feel like I'm so dead.
Does it make you uncomfortable how uninterested I am in you? Like, what the what is wrong with her?
It takes two people for a relationship to work.
I don't like it. She's mistreating him.
I don't know if you're really in this. Like, are you in?
The absurdity. I don't know if you're really in this. She's covering her face.
He could be with Bliss right now. Irina reveals that she has not been interested at all the entire time. And Zach is heartbroken about Bliss. He could have been with Bliss, experiencing Bliss. Irina also has eyes for Paul, her best friend Micah's man, who, by the way, is the twin of Zach.
No.
Zach, I know you're probably watching this. I'm just so sorry this is happening to you.
Honestly, I think about Bliss. I think about, like, fuck. Like, I hope you get a chance to see her when you go back to Seattle.
He's like, yeah, I've been thinking it the whole time. Yeah. Bliss would be trying to figure out what their dynamic was.
Yeah.
She's not even participating.
You talking to Paul for 5 minutes.
This is wild.
Like, I was so inspired and excited about our conversation, and I was like, why haven't I had one of these conversations with Zach?
He hates her.
Yeah.
He's over her, and I'm over her.
I don't think it's going to work out.
She's like,
but wait,
I'm not done being on TV.
Yes.
I'm not gonna pinpoint and be like, oh, well, you did this, you shaved your arms and legs. I'm not gonna sit here and point all these things like I don't like about you.
Oh, no! I'm not gonna be petty and say like, you're ugly, you smell like you're a horrible person. I wouldn't say those things.
She keeps making herself look worse.
I'm so glad that we did try. And
I don't know how hard you tried, but.
Mama.
Thank you.
They're both going to therapy.
She's not going to therapy.
They're going to the red table.
He's going to the red table. She's going to jail.
That red table. Yeah. She should say, it's an experiment. I really wanted to participate. Yeah. And when I realized we weren't a vibe, I didn't really know what to do.
Yeah, she'd be like, I panicked. I was insecure. She could have all these different things.
He is being so nice to her. He should be reading her. So they're back from Mexico, and the four remaining couples move in with their sig other.
In beautiful Seattle, Washington.
Do you like Seattle?
Yeah, I do.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Is Seattle romantic?
It's prohibitively costly.
I've ruined hotel sheets in Seattle. Zach left the show now, but he wants to see Bliss in Seattle. So they unpack everything that's happened, and Bliss was right about Irina. I want her to be like, so how did you propose? And him to be like, I sang.
Can I sing it to you? Yeah.
She stands up and sings Shallow. Shallow.
Ra, ra, ooh, la, la. How are you interpreting this as number two, as the girl not chosen?
In this sense, she gets to say, I told you so. So she kind of has all the power.
Okay.
Right? So she's probably like, you got scammed.
Okay.
I knew she was bogus.
Yeah.
I told you she was bogus.
And that makes sense.
He likes her so much more than he liked Irina.
Yeah.
No one will understand. I know that's such a dumb thing to say.
She talks like a Kardashian. Maybe if you knew how to run a business, you'd know what it takes to run a business, but you don't. So. Don't even. Micah and Irina see each other in Seattle, and Micah's like, you were coming after Paul.
Fuck Irina, bitch.
Being all feely in the pool, and like, that was like behind, like, my back. And, like,
I really appreciate you a lot, by the way.
She's like pivoting instead of owning up. Did you have my fiance? And like, she's like, I love your skirt.
Literally not why we're on, like, this experiment.
The nature of this is not to just get your golden ticket to Mexico so you can play the field.
God, she's
that's not the experiment. That's
wild.
Every other dating show. Zach has hung out with Bliss a few times and he's trying to make up for it. He's real confident about not falling off his boat. Could you imagine he's trying to be all slick?
Oh my God.
What are you doing?
She's like, there better be a Cinnabon in there.
Yeah.
If that's a ring, I'm gonna push you off this boat. He's gonna sing again.
You're everything that I've been looking for my entire life.
If he f-ing sings, Jennifer, you're never gonna see me again.
Girl, with arms wide open.
Running through this f-ing light.
Will you marry me?
Is that music that you're talking about?
Oh yeah, it's always.
And then you're on a boat and you've got a ring and you're kissing the brown haired girl.
I really thought you might say no.
Well, when you ask a yes or no question, you have to be prepared for both answers. Marshall and Jacquelina are having problems.
She's over the bullshit, she's over the drama.
She's over the halitosis.
You didn't want to sit here and talk. You're like, I'm leaving.
If you're in a fight and you flee the scene to cool off, I think that's being responsible.
You're never aggressive.
That's not who I am.
I read this energy immediately. Yeah. I didn't want to say it earlier.
Yeah.
But she seems like she would want a big aggro
dude.
Kate,
you're not clapping at me. You better fix it.
Is that not me?
Peasant.
Peasant.
Peasant. She said, you're being a peasant.
You're being a peasant.
This is what marriage is. This is what a committed relationship
is. No, that it looks like two people who don't want to hang around each other.
Oh, come on, girl. Girl, go get you a man who can man up.
So crazy.
Give me a break. She treated him like just now.
So crazy.
So, Jacquelina, instead of meeting up for her wedding fitting, she goes to meet up with Josh.
You're a strong woman. You could be cussing me out.
They seem like they already have better chemistry.
Yeah, they seem like a couple. He looks like an MMA fighter.
She wants her pussy annihilated.
Annihilated.
Told him to, you know, be more aggressive and boss up.
But also the way to say that is, I prefer a man who's dominant, whatever. Yeah. You don't say boss up, man up. Ugh. This is not ever part of the experiment.
Right.
I don't know why they're allowing these people to go investigate their second and third choices.
Yeah.
But I don't care for it.
Marshall goes back to their apartment to talk to Jackie about what happened, why she didn't show up to the fitting.
Don't do it, Jackie.
Don't do it, Jackie. Don't, you drop her like a bad habit. You just move on.
Have I encouraged conversation? Yeah.
I don't like people asking themselves questions and answering them.
It's stupid.
Do I ask myself questions? Yeah. Yes.
Do I look gorgeous and hot? Yes.
Yes.
My nipples poke through my satin chemise? Yeah.
No, and I didn't have that feeling, and I tried.
Everybody's lying. Every straight person is lying.
I would like the ring back because I don't think that you deserve it.
I'm gonna keep the ring because I accepted it because I wanted to marry you.
Oh,
whoa.
You can keep the ring. Every time you look at that thing, I want you to be reminded.
He's cursing her. Every time
you shame me.
I don't know if I'm gonna be with anybody. Damn, I'm crazy.
Thank you. Thank you. Finally, the awareness is so sickening.
She said, you know what? Damn, I'm crazy.
Girl, I am fucked up.
At least these couples are not going to the altar if they're really that certain that it's not a go.
Right.
So Chelsea had a very specific fantasy she wanted to partake in before the wedding. She and Kwame are living that out, and it is boudoir photography. Girl, you don't have to get married to do a photo shoot.
No.
This is our engagement photo shoot.
Oh, really? Okay.
We have two matching underwear sets.
Okay. Ann Getty. It's gonna give Ann Getty. It's really gonna give Ann Getty. She's gonna be a caterpillar.
She's gonna hold him as a baby.
This is not engagement. This is not engagement. Engagement is supposed to be like, you know, backyard by a fence, holding hands, like casual.
Yeah.
Save the date. Save the date for what? The orgy? Our wedding sponsored by adamandeve.com.
Yeah, yeah. Use offer code FISTME.
You know what, though? Love your body. Yeah, photograph whatever. Enjoy it while it's young and tight.
Yeah, yeah. All right, Chelsea and Kwame's wedding day.
I do have cold feet.
You should have cold feet, right?
On the wedding day of the person you met on a reality television show?
But even
show?
Normal weddings.
Yeah.
You'd be like, this is...
Yeah. All his friends are hot.
Yeah. Trixie, as the first bridesmaid, you have to take the loads of every man over on that. Well... I guess I care about my friend, so I guess I'll do it. Oh, God. Can I borrow your bouquet?
You promised to love her for as long as you both shall.
I don't think he's gonna say yes.
I do.
Oh.
You're like disappointed that they didn't. You're like, oh, God.
I think marriage sucks. It's so hokey and corny and tired and played out.
I want everyone to have the right to do it.
Sure.
But I think it's corny. If I'm with you forever, it's not because I got the state of California involved.
Hello, thank you.
Chelsea and Kwame, congratulations. But you know why the foundation of this is working out? They have actual physical attraction.
Yes.
The couples that clicked in the pod and no attraction, it does not work out.
No, because it was the f-ing point. So we are in attendance at Micah and Paul's wedding. Gorgeous mountain vista. Those parents look wealthy.
Pills.
They're giving
pills.
Pills.
Press pills. Xanax. Snorting a Xanny.
Xanny is a goofball.
What were you say they're giving?
Connecticut.
Oh, they're giving pills in Connecticut.
Walter, do you have a pill? I'm awfully bored.
Diane, do you have a pill?
Have discovered in each other.
I think she looks really pretty.
She really does.
That bra strap, I can't abide. No, my God. Mary.
I mean, I can only imagine the costumer on this Netflix program being like, they're probably going to break up in 2 days. Who cares? Great, it fits. Your bra strap's fine.
Ways of choosing one another for as long as your souls are united.
Hater. The hater friend.
The best thing that I can do for us is to give you the opportunity to answer first.
Nobody's ever said, I'm not answering, you answer first.
I love you.
Oh, it's a no. It's a no, bitch.
She knows.
It's
she
knows. A no.
I don't think that we can choose each other right now.
Sometimes it's like just a dose of sanity and the people go, I really like you, but I only 3 weeks in like you.
Yes.
I can't marry you yet.
Yes, I'm not insane.
I want it to be known that like.
Oh!
That's hard.
Yeah, it's tough.
But listen, he didn't say never. He said.
Not now.
Not immediately. Now her friend's laughing. And look at it this way. She didn't waste a bunch of money on a dress.
Yeah.
She went cheap. So far, we've had one marriage and one no marriage. It's Tiffany and Brett's wedding. It's my favorite. I really like them.
Yeah, he is so
He's
hot.
Gorgeous.
He's crazy.
We love black love, black joy, and we especially love all white suits.
How stressful would it be to wear a suit that white?
Oh my God, I can't wear makeup.
Couldn't do anything.
My white, bald skin, I would look like a televangelist.
Yeah, it'd be horrible. Like an usher in a like poltergeist movie.
Marshall! Marshall's like, I've already been treated better today than my whole relationship.
I thank you for just being you.
Oh, she really loves him.
You have been consistently yourself.
Which is how you make the process work.
Yeah.
And decided to get married.
Sight unseen. They love to say it.
They sure f-ing do.
Oh, they really love each other.
Love her lashes.
Oh, and both their families are excited. That also rarely happens.
Yeah.
All right, so it's Bliss and Zach's wedding day. We didn't see this one coming.
My favorite song is I Hope You Dance by Leanne Wombat.
What the f***? Unless you are a sophomore cheerleader who lives in Kansas, that should not be your favorite f***ing song. That song, for that to be your favorite song, if you're a soccer mom in Illinois in 2001, that can be your favorite song. What would your wedding song be?
Who let the dogs out? Maybe Mambo number 5?
Car wash,
yeah.
I remember it all very well. Looking back, it was the summer I turned 18. It would be a Reba-themed wedding, and everybody has to wear a little red wig in one look.
Never settle.
She looks great.
Face card is yanking.
Yeah, you can't f*** with a good face like that. Oh, he really likes her. Well, I think their connection was genuine. I think that
love him.
He picked the wrong person, but he always liked her.
I do.
Okay.
Great.
Second chances.
Love him.
Hot. We love him. I want to know more. I'm open to the option. Irina's in the back of the wedding, fuming.
Yeah.
Smoking cigarettes and fuming.
You're my husband.
You're my wife.
Oh my God. Straight people are so wild. It's the same thing. You're my husband. We're married. You're my wife. I'm your wife. We're married.
And Bliss and Zach have their first dance to the song that started it all.
And baby, this is huge.
Still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Do you like how I'm making fun of them and I know the words?
I love that.
God. You know, more than other seasons though, the ones that did get married, I really do think they love each other.
This is huge for them.
One of my favorite things is that eventually the reunion will come out.
Oh,
and that's when they all get together and scream.
Oh, fabulous.
It's fierce. This reunion's gonna be fierce.
This show had everything.
It had love.
Disappointment.
It had blindness.
White gowns, beautiful gowns.
Weddings.
Horrible music.
Cupcakes.
Peasant weirdos.
Flirting.
The whole range of human romantic drama unfurling before your very eyes.
Boudoir photography.
Deceiving backstabbing.
Leanne Womack, I hope you dance.
So why don't you go ahead and check out Love is Blind season 4 right here on Netflix.
Goodbye. Bye-bye.